I'm Dr. Philip E. Stieg, Professor and Chairman of the Department of Neurological Surgery at Weill Cornell Medical Center, New York Presbyterian Hospital.
Do we have a T2 weighted image?
As a neurosurgeon, the areas that I have specific and particular expertise in include the treatment of intracranial aneurysms, arterial venous malformations, acoustic neuromas, and trigeminal neuralgia.
This sucker goes way out there. But I think that, I bet it dies right there.
The things that I focus on as a neurosurgeon can be categorized into two broad areas, called cerebrovascular surgery and skull-based tumor surgery. Cerebrovascular surgery focuses on the diseases of blood vessels in your brain. And skull-based tumor surgery focuses, as it sounds, on tumors that are located at the base of your skull. Many of the techniques that we use for the treatment of cerebrovascular disease and skull-based tumors employ what is referred to as minimal access or minimally invasive techniques. This means that we use a microscope and often we use an endoscope to see around corners. By using these minimally invasive techniques, we are able to make smaller incisions and pull on the important brain structures much less. With this, we find that the patients make a faster recovery, and we believe that they will also make a better recovery. When a patient comes to see me with a specific neurosurgical problem, there are four basic questions that I ask for them that I believe they should ask of me, and that includes, what do I have, what does it mean to have it, what can I do about it, and what are the risks associated with doing that? Computers have changed the way all physicians manage their patients. Most importantly, in neurosurgery, computers have improved our ability to visualize the disease within the brain. What I'm looking at here is this is the tumor right here, and all this green stuff is the important fiber tracts that we had to miss when we were doing the biopsy. We are able to integrate the information that we get from MR scanners and CAT scanners, create three-dimensional images, and then integrate that information into our microscope and lay it over the image that we're actually seeing real time in the operating room. All of these things, I believe, make us better neurosurgeons because we have a better understanding of the anatomy and the disease process. With that better understanding, we firmly believe that the patient's going to have a better outcome. I love taking care of patients. There is no greater feeling that I have than when a patient wakes up from a surgical procedure that I've performed and they smile and they realize that they're alive and that all of their neurological function is stable.